The focus of agricultural research at NARI has been to work on different locally grown crops such as cotton and safflower, or some new crops such as sugar beet and sweet sorghum. So we have been doing research mainly on these two crops at present, and in addition to this we have also started research on fodder crops. Our sweet sorghum project aims at producing hybrids and varieties which can give high stalk yield as well as grain yield. And the juice which is produced from the stalk is being converted into syrup without chemical additives. This syrup at present is being marketed under the brand name Madhura, and we are also trying to automate the process of syrup production so that it can be taken up by the farmers on larger scale. At present, a large amount of edible oil is being imported into India, and because of this, the farmers are getting away from oilseed production since this oil is being sold very cheaply in the market. So we want to make safflower acreage higher, so that for that we are producing high yielding varieties and have been able to get as much as 38% oil in the seed. To express their high genetic potential, animals require good quality nutrition. Therefore, NARI is popularizing high protein fodder species such as Lucina or Subabur, and stylo species Hamata and Siebrana. In addition, drought tolerant species like prickly pear cactus and buffel grass are being studied for their fodder potential.
I came back from United States in 1981 and started working on the problems affecting local population, because I wanted to find out what I can do with my knowledge that I gained from United States. So the availability of electricity was one of the things that I saw, and so we developed the whole technology of producing alcohol using solar energy, and then developed lanterns and stoves to run on alcohol. And in fact, we developed a unique device called land stove, which was a combination of lantern and stove. We gave 23 land stoves for testing in the unelectrified huts near our institute. While testing them and interacting with these people, we realized that besides clean lighting and cooking energy, they also need clean drinking water. So we developed a unique technology of using solar energy to produce clean water. The dirty water is filtered through 4-layer sari cloth and then put in the solar tubes. The high temperature in these tubes completely kills the coliforms and makes the water clean. This technology has been made available free of cost. And then we also looked around and saw a massive amount of air pollution taking place, because the farmers were burning their sugarcane trash and other residues. In fact, that is a very major problem right now in the country, of burning the residues, and it pollutes the whole environment and also is a tremendous loss in energy. So we thought, what can we do to produce energy from sugarcane trash? And that is how our gasification program started. We are one of the pioneers of gasification in India. Since I come from Lucknow, where in 1950s and 60s the major transportation was cycle rickshaw, I was always bothered by the inefficiency of cycle rickshaw, and I thought that this is an opportunity. So I thought of using the technology of motors and batteries for producing electric cycle rickshaw. So we embarked on a unique program of developing electric cycle rickshaws. In fact, we were the pioneers in India or anywhere else in when we started our program in 1995. We developed quite a number of rickshaws, and finally, we ended up with developing a complete electric rickshaw called Eleksha, and we are very proud to say that that was copied by a large number of people. In fact, a large number of electric rickshaws that exist in this country may have come from this program. In early 1990s, we were instrumental in setting up a national policy on energy self-sufficient talukas. This policy has been run by Ministry of Non-Conventional Renewable Energy Sources. NARI was the principal author of this policy, which envisages that the agricultural residues of each taluka will be used to produce all the electricity consumed by that taluka. Then we thought that we should put all these things together for sustainable development, and Bajaj were very kind to give us a grant for setting up the Bajaj Center for Sustainable Development in, and we would like to use this center for training civil society and other and corporate people on issues of sustainable development.
Sheep and goat rearing is practiced widely even in the drought-prone areas, and it is the only source of livelihood for the most underprivileged people. And that is why Mr. Nimbkar, the founder of NARI, thought of developing more productive sheep and goat breeds. And that was also one of the recommendations of the Sheep and Goat Commission of the Government of Maharashtra, appointed in 1989, of which Mr. Nimbkar was the chairman. And that is how the Animal Husbandry Division was established. The major achievement of the division is the development of the 60% more productive Nari Suvarna sheep. This was achieved by introducing the FEC-B or Barula gene from the small Garol sheep of Sundarban into the local Lonan Deccani sheep. The Nari Suvarna sheep are proving to be extremely profitable. Further improvement in the Nari Suvarna is continuing in the 400 ewe nucleus flock that we have at the division. For genetic improvement of the local goats through crossbreeding, we imported the world's best meat goat breed, the South African Boer goat. The Boer goat has proved to be a fast-growing and hardy breed for Indian climates and conditions, and has earned good money for smallholder goat owners as well as for entrepreneurs owning more sophisticated goat farms. We have also been instrumental in importing and disseminating the tropical dairy goat breed Damascus from Syria and Cyprus.
An initiative of the division for the improvement of indigenous goat breeds since 2009 has been performance recording and selection amongst about 5,000 Usmanabadi goats in villages in four districts of Maharashtra under ICR All India Coordinated Research Project for the Goat Improvement.
We have established the appropriate technology for artificial insemination under field conditions in India, and ours is the only buck semen freezing laboratory that is producing semen straws in large quantities in India. We have made available semen of the Boer, Damascus and Usmanabadi breeds, and the technicians who are using this semen have reported conception rates of 50 to 60%. Finally, I would like to say that the Animal Husbandry Division would like to strengthen its position as a center of excellence in applied sheep and goat research. We would like more and more rearers to benefit from our work, and I would like to thank all the past and present staff of the division for their dedicated and sincere hard work.